Usually, when I see a portable monitor, I imagine something modest that can expand the workspace of a laptop. But this freaking monitor can simply replace it. It's 19 inches, 4K resolution, 144Hz refresh rate, while running on a single Type-C cable. But is it really portable? And how good it actually is? I've been using it for 1 month, and I'm still not sure who its target audience is. I will share my experience in different usage scenarios, what I liked and what I didn't. Let's start with unboxing and a disclaimer that this monitor was sent to me for a review, but there will be no content moderation, and I will not limit myself in what I want to say. So, in addition to the monitor itself, the packaging includes a 25W power adapter, screws for VESA mounting, two Type-C cables, and a mini HDMI to HDMI cable. All cables are 1 meter long. The monitor itself weighs approximately 1.3 kilograms. There are rubberized legs on the bottom and a kickstand on the back. When the kickstand is lifted, the ports become accessible, and now we can see two Type-C and one mini HDMI port. Why not a full-size HDMI for a monitor of this size? That's the question. On other side, we have the control buttons. I found the settings interface inconvenient because the buttons are on this side and the indicators are at the bottom of the monitor. So at first you have to guess which button is responsible for what, and you need time to get used to it. Fortunately, I rarely need to use them. Next to the buttons, there is an OTG port, which, as far as I understand, can be used to connect a keyboard or mouse. But how many micro USB devices do you have? I have none, so I couldn't even test it. It has a QLED panel, and in the display hierarchy, it's often positioned as a middle ground between IPS and OLED. But it's not about being better than a high-end IPS. It's about the character of the image. The quantum dot layer here gives this monitor a clear edge in color volume and vibrancy. While a standard portable IPS might look a bit dull, the QLED makes colors pop. It may lack the perfect blacks and infinite contrast of an OLED, but this portable display still delivers a vivid, punchy image, making media and games look great. It's really nice to work on this monitor too. Table sheets, coding, editing, regardless of what you're planning to use it for. As I mentioned earlier, a single Type-C cable is sufficient for full 4K 144Hz. I tested it on a MacBook M1 Pro and on my OneX Player handheld. If you're worried that it will drain your laptop battery, I measured its power consumption for you.
At maximum brightness, it consumes 16-17 watts. This is 80%, 15 watts. This is 50%, 13 watts. And this is 20%, around 7 watts.
The monitor also supports HDR and FreeSync, which is basically AMD's version of VRR. And let's be honest, your frame rate will fluctuate in 4K resolution. And this is crucial to avoid screen tearing. But you gotta make sure that your device can actually handle running games at 4K. Not every desktop GPU can manage that, let alone an external GPU or a laptop, which is most likely what you will use if you plan to travel with this monitor and use it for gaming. If you're worried about gaming performance, here's the trick. Because it's a standard LCD structure, even with the QLED layer, you still can use integer scaling. Basically, when you switch resolution to Full HD, four physical pixels act as one single pixel of the image. This gives you a much sharper 1080p experience than you would normally get from non-native resolutions, making it a great workaround if your hardware can't handle games in 4K. However, if you want to achieve the full 4K 144Hz using the mini HDMI, you need to swap the cable that comes in the box, because it's only version 2.0, which maxes out at 4K 60Hz. To be honest, for a long time I thought there was something wrong with my monitor. I couldn't even imagine that the monitor costing that much would it come with a proper cable. And then I immediately remembered how my USB 3 compatible iPhone came with a USB 2 cable in the box, so it doesn't really surprise me anymore. I found the mini HDMI cable version 2.1 for less than 10 euros, and now I'm finally getting the maximum potential out of this monitor when it's connected to the GPU. Let's talk about its portability. I had a business trip, and this monitor could be useful there. It wouldn't fit in my backpack, especially an LTT backpack, but it fits into my carry-on luggage. It's easy to scratch it, so I would consider buying an additional cover, which would also provide a place to hide the cables. By the way, in German airport, I was asked to open my carry-on luggage for inspection, because they were interested in the monitor. Not in the way they liked it, no. They thought I was secretly trying to hide a laptop or something like that in there. So they told me to take it out in the future just like a laptop, so keep that in mind. Upon arrival at the hotel, I was able to set up a fairly comfortable workspace for myself. I showed this monitor to my colleague, and he was quite interested in it for himself because he travels a lot and always with a carry-on luggage. By the way, I watched a series like this by attaching it to my knees. I know it looks silly, but it turned out to be very convenient. However, you don't have to be a traveler to appreciate this monitor. It might be a great choice for a clean, minimalistic setup. Combine it with these angled adapters, and you can completely hide the cables for a sleek look. But mostly, it will depend on your budget. I think it's pricey, but my colleague wasn't put off by the price at all. Because in a way, the monitor has a unique set of features. And if you specifically need it for work or some other purposes, then the price may not stop you. Besides, I was given promo codes that will help you reduce the price. Feel free to use them. If you have any further questions, ask me in the comments, and I will do my best to answer them. Bye!